All right, good afternoon. Thanks you everyone for coming. To my left is Captain Bob Wyford, charge of the Criminal Investigation Division. To my right is lead detective on this case, Detective Sergeant Jess Higgins, and Mayor Deneen Sirachi. Thank you all for taking the time to join us. Today we will address a significant development in an investigation involving a former officer from nearly three decades ago. As this is an ongoing criminal investigation, and we won't be able to answer every question, but we are committed to transparency and offering as much information as we can on these recent revelations. As of today, the Bureau has arrested two men in connection to sexual assault crimes that occurred in Lancaster City in late 1997. Roberto Rosario has been charged with rape, involuntary deviant sexual intercourse, and sexual assault for an incident allegedly occurring on December 27, 1997. The second man was a former Lancaster City police officer tasked with investigating the alleged rape committed by Rosario. Former officer Andrew Selby, who also goes by the name of Scott, is accused of sexually abusing the victim during the investigation that ensued in the days following the alleged assault by Rosario. Selby is currently facing charges of rape and sexual assault. Detective Sergeant Higgins began an investigation after she initially became aware of the incidents on March 3, 2024. The victim provided a detailed account of the violent abuse they suffered at the hands of Roberto Rosario, and additionally disclosed that Selby, who was entrusted with the investigating the initial incident, sexually assaulted them the days after the violent attack they endured. As a result of this investigation by the Lancaster City Bureau of Police, two more victims have come forward alleging instances of abuse involving Selby dating back to 1999. These incidents reportedly occurred during periods when Selby was both on and off duty while serving as a Lancaster City police officer. Selby left the Lancaster City Police Force in August of 2000. Selby is additionally charged with rape, involuntary deviant sexual intercourse, sexual assault, and statutory sexual assault of a 12-year-old victim, and the attempted rape, attempted statutory sexual assault, and attempted sexual assault of another victim in November of 1999. The arrest of former Officer Selby in connection with these heinous crimes is deeply shocking and saddens all of us at the Bureau. We feel it's crucial to highlight that we are committed to ensuring that all individuals, regardless of their position or past affiliations, are held accountable for their actions. We are fully dedicated to pursuing truth and justice as we continue with this investigation. We believe there's potential for additional victims who may come forward as we further investigate this matter. We encourage anyone who may have been affected by or has any information regarding the conduct of former Officer Selby to please contact our office. Next, I'll invite Mayor Sirachi for a brief word, then we will open the floor for any questions.
Thank you, Chief. Though I cannot comment on the Police Bureau of the 1990s, I am really here today to just say how proud I am of the work of Detective Sergeant Higgins and the Bureau in bringing the survivors of these crimes one step closer to justice. Anyone needing support, I want to encourage them to reach out to the YWCA's Sexual Assault Prevention and Counseling Center. And I also want to underscore Chief Mendez's sentiment that we are committed to holding all offenders, despite their position or status, accountable for their actions. And now I'll turn it back to Chief for any questions that we can answer.
Chief, so how many victims in all is former Officer Sully accused of being involved in sexual assaults?
Three victims that we currently were able to charge for.
Three. And what are the ages of the three victims?
So it was 12, 16?
16, 12, and relatively close to the 12.
16, 12, and relatively close to the 12. We're not going to disclose that.
16, 12, and 12.
Relatively close. We're not going to disclose that age at this time. So relatively close to that age group.
Is the attempted assault included in the three victims?
Correct.
Okay.
Yes. Are all of the big alleged victims female?
They are.
Yes.
Robert Rosario, his involvement, what charges is he facing again? And is he also being charged with the same amount of victims?
So no, Robert Rosario was charged with rape, involuntary deviant sexual intercourse, and sexual assault. That would have been from the 15-year-old that former Officer Selby initially took the investigation from.
And then what is the time frame between the original Rosario investigation and these two other incidents?
I believe roughly 2 years.
Yes.
Roughly 2 years.
2 years later or before?
Later.
The break in the case was from the March 2024 victim coming forward?
Correct.
Can we get spellings on Rosario and Selby's names?
Yeah, what?
Brilliant,
yeah. Okay.
Yeah, we have a release we're going to we'll put out also, I believe.
So, Chief, obviously, you probably weren't on the force back then. Maybe you weren't.
I was not.
How's this make you feel?
Just as the law enforcement community, it's upsetting. You know, it's just another, you know, black eye on the whole law enforcement community, and we're going to do our best to weed that out.
What is the status of Officer Selby at this time?
So he's currently in custody awaiting arraignment. I don't believe he's been arraigned yet.
Not that I'm aware of.
Yeah.
The Lancaster County Prison?
He's in custody right now.
Here or elsewhere?
He's in custody awaiting arraignment.
And what is Mr. Rosario's status?
Was he arraigned yet?
He was.
He was arraigned last night. I don't know the what bail he received.
We can get that to you.
Sure. What assistance, how are you folks helping them, reaching out to the victims in this case? What are you doing to help them?
I'll let Sergeant Higgins talk about that.
So the victims have
already... Can you get a little closer to the mic?
Sure. The victims have already been contacted and are aware of the development in the case. Additionally, they have been offered counseling services. Some have already sought counseling services, and they've been offered counseling services in addition to that.
Are you anticipating more victims coming forward from these two officers?
We believe there's a possibility that more victims will come forward.
And there is only one officer. Rosario is not a police officer. Only Officer Selby. We worked for the Bureau for 6 years.
Mayor, a question for you. So when you have this kind of a black eye that people tend to generalize police as a whole, even though that's obviously not the case, how does this hurt the community? How does it hurt police department? How does it hurt you?
I think as a woman, it hurts me because rape is a terrible crime, and I have a lot of empathy, and I'm also very inspired by these victims coming forward at this time. And I can't speak to what the police bureau was in the 1990s. I don't know what that was. I don't know the lengths in which professional standards were upheld, background checks. There were no body cameras. I can't speak to that. What I can speak to is how pleased and proud I am of the Bureau today in helping these victims get a step closer to justice.
Chief, is there an affidavit and is there a mugshot?
So we can get you the mugshot once they are placed on record for that.
Will that happen today?
Yes. Yeah, we can put that out.
Where did Selby go after he left the force in 2000?
I have no idea what... former Officer Selby did when he left the police department.
And I'm sorry, how long was he on the force?
It's roughly 6 years.
Did he leave the force voluntarily?
He left in 2000.
In good faith?
He left in 2000. All right. Okay, it's time for one more question.
Okay.
All right, thank you. Appreciate you coming.